Hi there. Welcome to Green Active Family. Thanks for stopping by. At Green Active Family, we aim to provide you with the most up-to-date information about hidden dangers, chemicals, and toxins found in common nursery and household products so that you can make the most informed buying decision and to help you provide a toxin-free environment for your family. In this video, we are talking phthalates. What are they? Where are they found? Why are they bad? And what you can do about them. So let's get started. Phthalates, without getting all sciencey, are chemical components of phthalic acid used to make plastic flexible. Here are a few of the more common ones. And it's for this making plastic flexible reason that it has been dubbed the everywhere chemical. We wrap our food with it. We walk on it. We wrap our bodies with it. And it doesn't stop there. Phthalates are used in shampoo, perfume, hairspray, nail polish, mini blinds, wallpaper, plastic pipes, storage bags, and even medical devices, including blood storage bags and medical tubing. And the list goes on and on. Of real concern is that phthalates are also found in many baby products. Baby shampoo and soap, bath toys, vinyl books, vinyl crib mattress covers, teethers, rattlers, inflatable toys, and yes, disposable diapers as well. Should we worry? Well, we all know babies are much more susceptible to chemical exposure. They put their plastic toys in their mouths, they spend many more hours sleeping on their mattresses than older children and adults. And we even put phthalates in the air for our children to breathe. Manufacturers use phthalates with fragrances. Think perfumes, colognes, aftershaves, scented laundry detergent and fabric softener, dishwasher detergent, liquid hand soap, and manufacturers are not required to list the individual chemicals on the label, so we don't even know we're doing it half the time. They've been used for years, so what do we really know? How bad can they really be? Good question. The research is limited. Many of the studies have been limited to lab testing with animals, which is a whole other debate. So we know there are phthalates, but we don't really know what impact they will have without further study. However, the few human studies have shown much cause for concern. Some experts believe phthalates are endocrine disruptors. Prenatal exposure to phthalates may be related to social behavioral issues. One South Korean study found a possible link between higher levels of phthalate metabolites and ADHD. And some studies have seen a connection to asthma and rhinitis. If phthalates are everywhere, what can we really do? Well, the answer is not much, unfortunately. We can take some solace in the fact that the US government in 2008, with the Consumer Product Safety Improvement Act, banned any children's toy or child care article containing more than a 0.1% concentration of the same 8 common phthalates we showed you earlier. Now, the act doesn't ban all phthalates, mind you, and the ones it did ban left the industry searching for alternatives. So, bring on another set of chemicals that need years of testing and study. I'll leave you with this. You can reduce the amount of phthalates for your family by finding an alternative to plastic food wraps. Use beeswax food covers or store in silicone containers or silicone bags, glass, or stainless steel. You may have already switched to canvas reusable shopping bags, but take it to the next level and stop with the individual plastic produce bags and stop buying bread in plastic bags, etc. Avoid buying sauces in plastic squeeze bottles. Look for bathroom and personal care products labeled as phthalate-free. Make your own laundry and dishwasher soap. It's easier than you might think. And for the babies and children, look for any plastic products to be labeled 1, 2, 4, or 5, which are generally considered the safest. For baby bottles, look for phthalate and BPA-free labels and the number 5 recycling code. Buy fragrance-free. Look for lotions and shampoo in bottles labeled 1, 2, 4, or 5, and never, ever heat food while it's still in its plastic container. For more information, click the link below in the description for further details and suggestions to go phthalate-free in your house, and we'll see you in the next video.